39-year-old Emmanuel Kashija is the relative of a suspect on remand of a cybercrime. He was arrested trying to bribe the Lira Chief State Attorney, Jonathan Okello, with 2 million shillings. The cybercrime suspects include Herbert Nwagaba, 26, a teacher by profession, and the director of Power Forex International, and Moses Mutesasire, 31, a marketing officer. The group is accused of using their company, Power Forex International, to defraud unsuspecting victims. Jonathan Okello, the Lira Chief State Attorney, confirmed the incident but declined to comment. Paul Eseru, the Deputy Resident City Commissioner, says over 2,000 youth were defrauded in Lango sub-region of money amounting to at least 2 billion shillings. One pensioner from Kole District lost 40 million shillings to the scam. Patrick Emot, who lost 30 million shillings, explains that the organization came to Lira in May last year and presented their business to them.
When we got somebody who came to bribe the state for the ongoing court for today, and actually, the state called me very early in the morning that I should first rush there. I did not tell me what I was, what he was calling me for. And when I went there, I got the person coming with the millions of money. He first brought 2 million, and again went back to get more money to add up to 7 million, as was told to me by the state. Unfortunately, his plan did not work. The state told me. I rushed there in time and arrested him.
Godwin Adrico from Arua, who worked with the company, fled his house fearing for his life.
I was once working for Power Forex. Then when things turned wrong, I had to quit my own town. I had to come to Lira for my safety. Because Power Forex bosses, they were using us local leaders to bring more people. So when things turned wrong, they disappeared and left us just suffering. And our people started looking for us, others were arresting us, my things were destroyed. So what we did was to bring them to Lira Court. We found a way of arresting them and they brought them here.
This report was compiled by Hudson Apunyo for the news.